Yeah, good morning dear students. Today we are going to learn about the formation of lymph. Okay, so when blood passes through the capillaries, the blood is filtered due to high blood pressure at the arteriolar end of the capillaries. So if you see the arteriolar end, so these are the arteries. Okay, so from arteries, it is arteries always sends in the capillaries, and capillaries always begins the vein. So this one is the artery, and these are the capillaries. Okay, when blood is entering into the capillaries, the blood enters into the capillaries with high pressure. Due to that high pressure, the blood is filtered at the arteriolar end. So this is called as arteriolar end. Okay, so what is the substances that are filtered means? Blood is filtered. The filtrate consists of plasma, some water, glucose, and small sized organic molecules and inorganic salts. So we can use the water, plasma, glucose, small sized organic molecules and inorganic salts are filtered. Where they are filtered? They are filtered into the extracellular spaces. Okay, so extracellular spaces means tissue spaces. Okay, so it is also called as tissue fluid or extracellular fluid. Otherwise, it is also called as interstitial fluid. But some substances like RBC and plasma proteins are not filtered. Okay, these RBC and plasma proteins enters into the venular end. Okay, RBC and plasma proteins reaches to the venular end. So when RBC and plasma proteins reaches to the venular end through the blood capillaries, the osmotic colloidal osmotic pressure of blood increases at the venular end. So due to increased osmotic pressure at venular end, 85% of extracellular fluid is returned back into the blood circulation at venular end. So 85% of extracellular fluid is returning back into the blood circulation at the venular end. Okay, then exchange of oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients and other metabolites with the tissue sucks. Okay, from extracellular fluid the oxygen and nutrients enters into the tissues, and again from tissues the carbon dioxide and metabolic waste materials reaches into the extracellular fluid. Okay, so 85% of the fluid has been returned back to the blood circulation. Then what about the remaining 15% of the fluid? The remaining 15% of extracellular fluid is collected into the lymphatic system. Okay, it is collected into the lymphatic system. So lymphatic system through lymph capillaries. Hence, it is called as lymph. So, what is the composition of lymph? Lymph is similar to blood plasma, but it is having lower concentration of nutrients, oxygen, and higher concentration of carbon dioxide and waste materials. So, in the lymph, which are more and which are less means, in lymph, the carbon dioxide and waste materials are more and nutrients and oxygen is less. Okay. So what the lymph is, what about the lymph? In lymph, erythrocytes are absent. In lymph does not contain RBC. And what the lymph contains? Lymph contains water, small plasma proteins, electrolytes. And leukocytes are also present mostly in the form of lymphocytes. So very important question this one. What type of leukocytes are present in the lymph means they are lymphocyte. And also it contains some coagulation factors like fibrinogen. It also contains antibodies, enzymes, hormones, vitamins, etc. And globulins, albumin and fibrinogen and sodium are present in less concentration or in the less quantities. Right. So this is about the lymph. Now let's go for the next one. Types of hearts or functions of lymphs also we can see here. Lymph returns some extracellular fluid and waste materials collected from body parts to the blood. And lymph also transports lymphocytes from the lymphatic glands to blood. And lymph also transports digested fats through lacteals and destroys microorganisms in the lymph nodes. So lacteal means large lymphatic duct present in the villi. So from the villi, the digested fats enter into the lacteal. Through the lacteal, again they reach to the blood circulation. Now let's go for the next one. This is not there in the NCERT. We'll cover the NCERT part. So next one is lymph. Spleen is there. Spleen is one of the important part. So spleen is the largest lymphatic organ. Then spleen is a bean-shaped structure. Color is red in color, and the spleen is made up of with reticular connective tissue. What are the functions of spleen? Spleen acts as secondary lymphoid organ, and it also acts as reservoir of RBC and WBC. Then spleen is the graveyard of RBC, and it acts as hemopoietic organ during embryonic stages. Hemopoietic organ means, you know that during embryonic stages, the spleen is acting as a hemopoietic organ, means it is producing blood cells. When it is producing the blood cells, it is producing the blood cells during the embryonic stages. But old RBC are destroyed in the spleen. So we are also calling the spleen as graveyard of RBC. Right. Now we'll go for the next one. Circulatory pathways. Okay. So circulatory pathways, if we take, there are two types of circulatory pathways. One is open type of circulation, and second one is closed type of circulation. Then if you go for the open type of circulation, blood flows through the open sinuses called open spaces called as sinuses. See, okay, this one is the blood vascular system of the cockroach. This is the heart, and this one heart opens into aorta, and this from the aorta, the blood enters into the sinuses, empty sinuses called as empty spaces called as sinuses. So in the sinuses, the cells and tissues are directly bathed in the blood. But in the open type of blood vascular system, the capillaries are absent. So the blood is flowing from heart to blood vessels to sinuses, sinus to again back to the heart. So where we can see the open type of blood vascular system. The open type of blood vascular system can be seen in arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata, and urochordata. So let us see the next one, closed type of blood vascular system. Okay, so closed type of blood vascular system. In closed type of blood vascular system, blood always flows through blood vessels and capillaries are present. Okay, blood flows from heart to arteries and arteries to capillaries, capillaries to veins, again from veins to heart. So closed type of blood vascular system is seen in annelida, cephalopoda and vertebrata. So annelida and cephalopoda belongs to invertebrates. Now let us see the types of hearts present in the vertebrates. Okay, let us see the first one before going to the types of hearts. Let us see heart origin. Heart is derived from mesoderm. And heart is always ventral in position, especially in the vertebrates. Okay, heart is always ventral in position. So if you take the vertebrate, the first one is fishes. In fishes, the heart consists of two chambers, that is one atria and one ventricle. Type of circulation is single circulation. That means the blood flows only once through the heart. And other characteristics we take, it is called as venous heart, as it always pumps the mixed blood. As it always pumps the deoxygenated blood. And it is also called as branchial heart, as it pumps the blood to the gills. Next one, amphibians and reptiles. We can see that in amphibians and reptiles, there are three chambered heart is present. In amphibians, there are two atria and one ventricle. But in reptiles, there is two atria but incompletely divided ventricle. Okay, so ventricle is not completely divided into two chambers. So it is incompletely divided ventricle. So types of circulation is incomplete double circulation in both the cases. Then in both the cases, blood is mixed in ventricles. So they always pumps the mixed blood. Then we go with the crocodiles, birds and mammals. There is a four chambered heart with two atria and two ventricles. And here we can see complete blood double circulation. So complete double circulation we can see in case of crocodiles, birds and mammals. So here in crocodiles, birds and mammals, oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood are flowing separately. They won't get mixed up. The right side of the heart pumps the oxygenated deoxygenated blood and left side of the heart pumps the oxygenated blood. So these are the types of hearts present in the vertebrates. Now let us go for the next topic, that is human circulatory system, that is heart in the man, structure of heart in the man, right?